positives with this one tonight? I know there's some things you probably aren't real happy about, but let's start with the positives. I thought your basketball team got off to a good start in this contest and really extended the lead out and had that 19-point lead at halftime. And early in the second half did the same thing, came out and played extremely well and pushed it out to 30-plus before UT Arlington made a push at the end. But you got to be pleased with the way they started both halves.
That's very important in terms of this position to have them, the way they perform offensively and defensively. I think I'm being smart with the basketball for the most part, but our defensive effort is very good in that first half. So we did some really good things, but you have to learn how to finish games. We have to finish games strong. Our main focus is once we got them, we want to try to finish. Very strong, do some positive things. We allowed their pressure to make us play fast, not play fast, turn the ball over. And not catching the ball and finishing at the rim.
Well, and that was going to be the one thing. In the first half, there was three fast breaks where we had a two-on-one or a three-on-one, didn't score. And in the second half, against the press, we never turned it over in the backcourt. We did a good job. It was when we would get inside the three-point line, we just weren't able to finish.
It's all about decisions. It's the decisions you made. You know, when we should make the pass, we went too late to make the pass. It's not that we don't see it or we're not trying to make it happen. It's just too late to make that pass. We have to know when to make it and who to get it to at the correct time. And once we do those things, we do it well. But when we don't, we turn the ball over or we miss a grand opportunity for us to really push the score up a little bit more.
Four straight game that Lulu Perry has scored 15 or more points. What she ended up with tonight, 21, tied her career high. And probably the most positive thing on that stat sheet is she was 6 of 7 from the floor. She took good shot selection tonight, I thought.
Right. Lulu Perry has definitely gotten herself into a tremendous groove. She's very confident in her abilities. And she just feels good about herself. And she's taken all the open shots when she's wide open. She puts it on her shoulders even when the shot clock is going down for us, and she'll take the shot. She's just a kid with a tremendous amount of talent, and she's starting to feel where she fits in, and she's doing very well offensively. But what I'm really proud of is she's gotten better for us defensively, which was probably her major adjustment to collegiate basketball, and she's doing tremendously well for us.
You played the second half without Courtney Hayes, and I thought she really provided a lot of energy and made good decisions in the first half before she caught that elbow, unfortunately, late in the half. I guess talk a little bit about what she provided you in the first half and then, again, without her in the second half.
Once again, you know, the energy that she brings, and then giving Janae Borden a moment of rest, it's always helpful. But Courtney Hayes just brings a tremendous amount of energy for us on the defensive end, and she's a tremendous rebounding guard as well. And she's physical, and that's what I really like, and that's missing with us when she's not out there, is the physical part of the game that she brings, the hustle, the energy that she brings, the loose balls that she'll get to, the sacrificing of her body that she'll give, and she's also conducting our show a little bit better than ever before. So that was truly missing for us, but she brought her leadership by sitting on the bench and being a leader from the bench area, so that was a positive. We're just hoping that she's okay and she's ready to go for the next one.
This is the first game on the back half of the WAC schedule, so you're 1-0 now. You're going to come back to Texas next week to play two more. And I know that the game plan is, hey, let's go 9-0, but it's a matter of one game at a time at this point.
It's definitely one game at a time. I'll tell you, it's one possession at a time for us. We have to understand time management. We have to understand all these little things. You got to understand the events of the game. And when we start to understand the events of the game and be under control with that understanding, we'll be a little bit better. But we have to get to that point, Malcolm, in order to be a great basketball team and to finish strong down the stretch.
Well, congratulations on the win tonight.
Thanks.